I know my own health, and I know that being pregnant in my condition is a serious issue. And I knew that this pregnancy would make me even seriously ill or possibly even kill me. I was terrified at the prospect of what this pregnancy might mean, of dying and leaving my two sons orphaned. But I also knew what the law says in Ireland, so I knew that I might have very few options. As soon as I discovered I was pregnant, I knew what was right for me, my life, my health, and my two sons. I knew that to continue this pregnancy, it would be too risky. And as much as I would have wanted to continue if it was safe to do so, I knew it wasn't. Because of this, I emailed the Abortion Support Network in the UK, explaining my situation, asking for advice. I explained what I thought would I'd likely have to travel to the UK to have an abortion. And when I went to my GP straight after this, I asked would it be safe to carry on with the pregnancy, and he told me that he couldn't answer that. So he referred me to St. Vincent's respiratory team. He passed on my questions about whether or not it would be safe, and if not, could I have a termination here in Ireland. This was when I started doing more research into pulmonary hypertension and pregnancy. I can't explain the fear that I felt when I saw the words mortality, high risk, heart failure. Everything I read confirmed my worst fears.
Unless there is, by a consensus of opinion, a real and substantial risk to the actual life of a woman, we cannot perform a termination in Ireland. That in this particular case illustrates it perfectly, because in this case, the doctors were not allowed to perform a termination to preserve the health of the patient. And there is a very big difference between performing a termination to preserve the life and performing a termination to preserve the health. The second complication is that as doctors, whilst we can provide information about termination of pregnancy in other jurisdictions, we cannot refer a patient, because that would be tantamount to procuring a termination. And that particularly impacts on women who have complex medical needs. We're all taught from the very first moment we enter medical school that good communication between doctors is essential for good outcomes. And when you have a situation where you have women with complex medical needs trying to access a medical treatment overseas in the absence of any referral or any good context as to her medical history, you actually increase the risk that patient is exposed to. And that's the problem with the Eighth Amendment.